lot of GIMP specific brushes out there too. And you know, these are like different charcoal brushes. These are very plain brushes. These are some more artsy brushes. And then here you have controls. You can change the opacity of the brush. You can change the scale of the brush, so it makes it bigger or smaller. That really actually makes it quite large. I'm gonna make it a bit smaller. And let me make the color black so you can see it. And then there's a cool set of things here called brush dynamics. And these are based on properties of your tablet. For example, the pressure sensitivity of the tablet. So since I have opacity checked off, that means the more forcefully I put the pen on the screen, the darker it's going to come out. And the lighter that I draw, the lighter it will come out. So you can see here, I'm going very light, and then I'm pressing harder, and you can see it get much darker. So very, very cool. You can also do some cool things here, like you can change it so that the size of the brush changes. See, and this is a very thin brush, so you can kind of see it where it's very thin, and then it press down, it gets a bit thicker. So this is just a cool little bag of tricks here that you can play around with in the GIMP, and it's all sensitive to your tablet. So cool stuff, right? So this is a very natural feeling kind of painting program. Like, here's an ink one. You can see how fluid that pen marks are. Some of these, this one is kind of like blades of grass, and you can change the colors here if you want to make it green. And some of these are kind of trippy. Like, look at this one. But there's many, many brushes in my paint to experiment with. And there's a lot of cool effects you can do with them. And I can show you a picture that I did earlier today, actually, with my paint. Here it is. So you can do some pretty cool things with my paint. You know, it's not a fully featured drawing program. Like, it doesn't have layers. The undo is very linear. And it only saves out to PNG, so that's it. So you can't really do special effects and expect to be able to tweak them later on. But at the same time, you know, it's a pretty cool application. So that's my paint. And next, I am going to show you Inkscape, which is my favorite application of all time. So here's Inkscape. And I'm going to change it so it's landscape. Here we go. So in Inkscape, when I'm using my tablet, I use the calligraphy tool. And this is how you get your pressure sensitivity working. This one, I think that's tilt, and this is pressure sensitivity. And then you can change the width of your line. Let's see. So you can see here, with the velocity alone, it changes the width. But also, if I go a bit slower, you can see that really changes. And see, I'm just pushing down very hard, so hard that actually my screen is moving back. But I'm pushing very hard, I'm getting a very thick line, and then I'm easing up, and it's getting very thin. Inkscape is great because it has layers. Everything that you draw is vector, so then if you decide you want to scale it up one of your drawings, you can do that, and it's completely lossless. You don't lose any fidelity of the line or anything. And it also has things like, here I'm simplifying the line, it's cutting down the vectors, the number of points in the vectors, but you know, you get to a specific part. Now this kind of looks like a penguin, actually. But yeah, so that is the tablet in Inkscape. And also, actually, Inkscape has these really cool preset pen effects. So here's the wiggly pen. Super thin. Actually, that's one I made myself. It has a very slow drawing, so when I'm doing very careful tracing, you can see it moves so slowly that it's a lot harder for me to make mistakes that way. Did we do splotchy? Oh yeah, it's splotchy. It's very, very splotchy. So, yep, and that's Inkscape. Here's one more fun tool in Fedora 12 that I think you might have some get some enjoyment out of, and it's called Agave, and it helps you pick out color schemes. So, you know, say you're trying to design a website, and you know maybe you like the color red, but you're not really sure what other colors to pick to go with it. It'll actually pick out some color schemes for you based on different mathematical representations of color relationships. So like this one is based on triads, you could pick based on tetrads, a color scheme, analogous color schemes, monochromatic, split complement, complements, and it gives you all the color codes and hex and RGB and HSV, and you can also even just use it to pick out random colors. So Agave is great. And oh, also you can save color schemes as your favorites, so you can keep a list as you go through. You can hit random, and if you see I like that one, you can just add it right there. So there you go. So I hope you've enjoyed all these things I've shown you in Fedora 12. And if you'd like to get your own copy of Fedora 12, just go to get.fedoraproject.org and you'll be able to try out all the things I showed you. Have fun!